Again, I had a one-to-one discussion, you know, with the colour sergeant. He taught me the sea drills. So let's have a look at what sea drills are then. So basically, the sea drills is the values of the British Army. So what does the C stand for? The C stands for courage. Naturally, soldiers need to have courage in order to do their job. Now, there's two types of courage, that being a physical courage, and let me give you an example, the actual physical courage to take that next step whilst you're out in Afghanistan, you get me guys? That physical courage. So courage is physical and it's also moral courage. The moral courage where if you see a fellow soldier that he's doing something that's wrong, perhaps he's stealing from other members of the unit, perhaps he's taking drugs, then it's up to you to have that moral courage to basically approach your seniors and tell them that it's not right because it's going against the army's values. So courage is C. Now we move on to the next one, which is D. D is basically discipline. Now we all know what discipline means. Self-discipline and basically disciplining others if they do things wrong. Like you discipline a child if they're being naughty. So that's the D. D is discipline. Then we have R, respect for others. We all know the British Army is a very cultural, you know, diverse organization, and having respect for other people is very important. Now you have another thing called integrity. So integrity is I. So what does integrity mean? Integrity means being truthful and being honest. So that's I for integrity. Now we move on to L. L is loyalty. Okay, now I'm from Northern Ireland, so an example of loyalty for me would be my loyal commitment for Northern Ireland to remain a union with Great Britain, which would be Scotland, England and Wales. So that's a form of my loyalty. But then loyalty would also be a form of your loyalty to the government as a soldier, stuff like that. So L is loyalty, and then we have S for selfless commitment. So what is selfless commitment? Well, selfless commitment is basically you helping other people, not being selfish. You know, there's actually a German word. I forget what that German word is, but it basically describes that you get pleasure from watching other people struggle. Okay, so let's say, for example, you're in the dormitory with your unit and you've done all your ironing and you're looking over and you're laughing because the new boy is struggling with his ironing. Okay, you find it very funny that the new boy is struggling because he can't iron. Well, under selfless commitment values, you would do the decent thing and you would go over and you would help that soldier and you would help them to learn how to iron their kit properly. So that's what we mean about selfless commitment. Now, moving on to the standards of the British Army, then the standards of the British Army is basically appropriate behaviour. So again, that's A for appropriate behaviour, the way you behave, the way you behave to others, etc, etc. Now, going on to the next stage of the standards is then lawfulness. Now, as a soldier, you're going to be under UK civil law. If you're in the British Army, you're going to be under, you know, the civil law that the UK abides by. If you're over on tour in operations, let's say in America, then you're going to be under international law, which is going to be like American law. But if you're in, like, let's say Afghanistan, again, you're going to be under international law. Some countries, you know, still have the death penalty. So the British Army, they don't want you, you know, being hanged by the loose. They don't want that. So what they do is they make sure that that country knows that if you do anything wrong, you're going to be punished by international law, which is probably going to be UK civil law, wherever you get what I'm saying, guys. So that's lawfulness, that's the standards. And the last standard is total professionalism. So again, The values is CDRILS, CDRILS, and the standards is appropriate behavior, lawfulness, in addition to totally perfection.